गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू न्यूमेरा ग्लोबल स्कूल ऑनलाइन टीचिंग क्लास। वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द लीव्स ऑफ द प्लांट, दैट इज ओवरऑल रिव्यू ऑफ दिस चैप्टर। ओके, यस्टरडे वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट व्हाट इज अ क्लोरोफिल, what are the different parts of the leaf, what is a stomata, what are the food for the plant, and today we will discuss how the food is used and stored in the plant. Yesterday we have seen what do you mean by the term photosynthesis, right? In photosynthesis, how the food is stored in the plant, the product is glucose. The glucose produces as food after photosynthesis is sent to different parts of the plant through the stem. So after the leaves prepare the food, that is the food is said to be glucose. It is sent to different part of the plant by means of the stem. The stem will carry the food and supply to all parts of the plant. And some of the food the plant will use to grow, right? And some on the rest it will store in different part of the plant. How? In the form of starch. Okay? So in our home, our mother, what they will do? Some of the rice he will take for cooking, and some of the rice he will store for some other days, right or not? The same here, some of the food the plants will use for growing, and the rest is stored in different parts of the plant. What are the parts? It may be in the root, it may be in the stem, it may be in the leaf, it may be in the flower. So it will store the food there. Some plants, they have parts that are specially modified to store the food. For example, in carrot, where the food is stored? Mainly in the root. And in the potato, the food is stored in the stem, in the form of the starch. I'm repeating again, how the food is used and how it is stored in the plant. Okay, so after the photosynthesis process, the plant will prepare the food. It is called glucose. So by means of the stem, the food glucose, it is distributed to different part of the plant. Some of the food the plant will take for growth, and remaining it will store in different part of the plants like root, stem, flower and leaf. For example, if you take the carrot, the food is stored in the root, and if you take the potato, the food is stored in the stem in the form of starch. This is how the plants will store and use the food. Clear? And then what are all the functions of the leaf? So as you all know, the leaf is the kitchen of the plant, which means it makes the food for the plant by carrying out photosynthesis. That is the first point. The green leaf, it is called the kitchen of the plant. Iska main kaam hai food prepare karna hai. Okay, it will make the food for the plant by photosynthesis product. Second point, the plant carries out the exchange of gases with air to stomata that are present on the underside of leaves. So what is the second point? The plants will take the carbon dioxide and it will release the oxygen. How? With the help of the stomata. Where they are present? They are present on the underside of the leaves. And then third point, some plants have leaves that are modified to store the food. If we take some plants, the leaves are used to store the food. Example, onion. And some of the leaves can even to catch the insect for the food. Example, pitcher plant, which we taught in the 7th chapter, right? Insectivorous plants, that is the leaf is modified into the pitcher plant, right? So these are all the three main functions of the leaf. First one, the green leaf is the kitchen of the plant to make the food for the plant by using photosynthesis. Second one, it carries out the exchange of gases, that is taking in carbon dioxide and giving out oxygen. How? By means of the stomata. The stomata are present on the underside of the leaves. And in some plants, the leaves are modified to store the food. Example, onion. And some plants even to catch the insects for the food. Example, pitcher plant. And the next one, we are going to learn about interdependence of plants and animals. What is the thing? Interdependence means what? How the plants are, animals are interdependent. Okay? So, plants and animals are interdependent. They help each other. What they're telling? Plants help the animals and animals will help the plants in many ways. The first point, the plants, they are called producers because they prepare their own food. So since they prepare their own food, they provide the food to the animals, right? Herbivorous animals. What are herbivorous animals? The plant-eating animals are called herbivorous animals. So the herbivorous animals, they will eat the plants, right? So, and animals and human beings, we cannot make their own food. So we are called consumers. Okay? So, they depend directly or indirectly on plants for food. So, this interdependent relationship, it is called as a food chain. Okay, so I'm repeating again, interdependence of plants and animals. Plants and animals are interdependent. They help each other in many ways. First one, plants provide food to the animals because plants are producers. They prepare their own food. But animals, including human beings, we cannot make our own food. So we are called consumers. So either directly or indirectly, we depend on plants for food. For example, vegetables we get from the plants. Fruits we get from the plants. Cereals, pulses, so we get from the plants. So this directly we are dependent. Indirectly means, suppose we are non-vegetarian. We eat chicken and mutton, right? So these chicken, sheep or goat, what they will eat? They were herbivorous animals, right? So if we eat that one, indirectly we are taking the plants, right? So like this, we directly or indirectly depends on plants for food. So this relationship, it is called a food chain. Okay, now see the diagram here. In page number 70, diagram is there. Plant is eaten by deer. And deer, it is eaten by lion. So this is the chain. The chain shows how different organisms are depend on each other. They are called food chain. And then, anyhow, the food chain, it will start with the producer. Producer means it is a plant. And then it ends with the consumer. Now see the diagram. The plant is said to be the producers, right? Deer, it is a primary consumer. And then lion, it is a secondary consumer. So food chain, it starts with the plant and end with the consumer, that is an animal. Okay, how plants are helpful to us and how animals are helpful to plants. First, green plants, they give out oxygen, right? So plants, they will take the carbon dioxide and they will use the oxygen. What the animals will do? Animals will take that oxygen and they will give out carbon dioxide. Then the plants will use this carbon dioxide, right, to prepare the glucose during photosynthesis. So plants give out oxygen where the animals are taking. Animals give out the carbon dioxide where the plants are using. So this is how both plants and animals are dependent on each other. Okay, so what they are telling, a food chain, it always starts with a plant and then it will end with an animal. And then plants give out oxygen and the oxygen is taken by the animals. Animals breathe that oxygen and they give out carbon dioxide. And the plants use that carbon dioxide to prepare the glucose. This is how they are dependent on each other. Okay. And then last one, we will see, do some activity. Okay. So an easy and simple activity we will do. It is very easy for you to test for the starch. So what is a starch? It is a food stored by the plant, right? Some of the food it is used for growing and some of the food they will, so the plants will store in the form of starch. So in this activity we are going to test for a starch. So what are the things you needed? Aapko kya kya chahiye ye test karne ke liye? Sirf aapko ek potato chahiye, a vegetable peeler chahiye, a dropper or a spoon and a small iodine solution. Iodine solution is present in the shops, nearby shops, any shops you can get this iodine solution. Okay, or simple, if you have the ink in your home you can able to test that. Okay, so first what you have to do, now take a potato, peel a portion of the potato. Okay, after peeling, what you have to do? You have to add a few drops of iodine. पहले क्या करना है, आपके एक आलू ले लो, आलू का थोड़ा पोर्शन पील करना है, उसका स्किन का रिमूव करना है. इसके बाद 2 to 3 ड्रॉप्स आयोडीन सोल्यूशन इसके ऊपर डालना है. तो वॉट विल हैपन, द कलर ऑफ द आयोडीन टर्न्स द ब्लूइश ब्लैक. अगर आपको डालने के आयोडीन डालने के बाद पोटैटो विल चेंज इनटू ब्लूइश ब्लैक, इफ ब्लूइश ब्लैक इज देयर देन स्टार्च इज प्रेजेंट इन दैट पोटैटो. ओके, व्हाट दे आर टेलिंग, टू टेस्ट फॉर योर स्टार्च यू हैव टू टेक वन पोटैटो, वेजिटेबल पीलर, योर ड्रॉपर एंड आयोडीन सॉल्यूशन. यू हैव टू पील योर पोर्शन ऑफ द पोटैटो. And then in that area, you have to add 2 to 3 drops of iodine solution. If that potato change into the blackish color, bluish black color, then starch is present there. If some other color is there, starch is not present there. This is the activity number 1. Then come to page number 69. Another one activity is there. But it will take so time, you can't able to do this activity in your home. Once the school open, we will discuss this activity in class. Okay, so students, today we have completed our 6th chapter, overall review of this chapter, and tomorrow we will discuss about 7th chapter, overall review. See you tomorrow, students.